Hi everyone, I am Dr. Soundara Raj. I am very happy to interact with you all through this video. In this video, I am going to present my lecture on the topic Importance of International Marketing, which could otherwise be named as Benefits or Need of International Marketing. These are all a few details of mine. After you watch the full video, if you find the video beneficial to you, give a like to the video. And do subscribe my channel so that you will get the notifications of my future videos. Let me present the topic Benefits or Need or Importance of International Marketing. The benefits of international marketing is presented into three categories. One, benefits to manufacturer. Two, benefits to economy. And three, benefits to the consumers. Now let's get into the details of the benefits of international marketing to the manufacturers. Number one, increase in market area. Definitely, a company which gets into international marketing goes places crossing the frontiers of its home country market. So obviously, the market size for their products and services will be expanded. Now the whole world constitutes their market. The global village itself is a market for the companies. There are a couple of companies which are really popular and have benefited out of international marketing. They are Philips, Nestle, Sony, Panasonic, Toyota, etc. They are selling their products worldwide, although their home country market is very, very small. And the second benefit of international marketing to manufacturers is increase in sales and profits. When the market size is expanded or increased, obviously you find increase in sale of the products for the companies which have entered into the international and global markets. That will finally result in maximization of profit. For some of the companies, their sales or turnover is much higher than that of the GDP of many small countries. The third benefit of international marketing to manufacturer is diversification of risk. With global marketing or international marketing, companies can diversify country risk, political risk, natural risk, economic risk, etc. For example, if there is a recession, natural calamity, law and order problem in one nation, then the company can concentrate on markets of other nations. The loss a company incurs or the decrease in sales a company faces in one country market where it finds all these problems, definitely that could be really compensated with the maximized sale in other country markets. Through international marketing, the companies are really enabled to diversify the risk what they undergo. The fourth benefit is economies of large scale. When companies produce their market offers in large quantity to meet out the increased demand for their products in the world market, the large scale production will definitely help the companies to bring down the cost of production per unit of their market offer. And that is what beautifully stated in the fourth point. Global image is the fifth benefit. MNCs, multinational corporations, sell their products throughout the world. It improves their corporate image and brand image. Due to global brand equity, these companies can easily launch new products, capture new markets, can even charge high price due to their deep or strong brand loyalty. So this is a fantastic benefit a company could enjoy entering into international markets. When a company takes its products to other country markets, the company makes its brands very popular among the consumers of other country markets. So this really contributes for enhanced image of the brands of the company which gets into global or international marketing. The enhanced image will certainly contribute for higher brand equity for the brands owned by the company, and it will also enable the company to gain popularity for the company name itself. This really helps a company to come out with new products and easily capture the markets, not only in the home country market, it is also made possible in other country markets where it is already entered. Then the second category of benefits or importance of international marketing is benefits to economy. Control over inflation. This is a superb point. In fact, global companies increase the supply of products in host nations. If in any nation domestic prices are rising, then it can import goods through international marketers, and thereby check the rising prices in the economy by increasing the supply of these goods. When a country's economy is suffering out of inflation, it can very well invite or import goods from companies of other countries. When such goods enter into the market or country with inflation, definitely it will contribute for reduction in the prices of such products. It will indirectly contribute for putting off inflation in the country which is suffering out of inflation. So this is an advantage out of control over inflation. And the second one is about increase in employment. Definitely, when companies go places in the entire world market, expand their market, by virtue of that, they involve in large production of their products, large-scale promotion, distribution, all these activities will certainly provide employment opportunities to many people around the world. And that is what about the point they have stated in the second one. And the third one is about increase in exports. International marketing increases exports and thus helps to earn precious foreign exchange. It helps to solve the problem of negative balance of payments. When a company enters into international marketing, definitely that company helps the home country nation to increase its foreign revenue. And the revenue generated by the company in the international market brought into the home country, it helped the government of the home country market to solve the problem of negative balance of payments. The next point is increase in standard of living of the people. Global marketing makes available the goods being manufactured in other nations. The persons living in least developed nations and developing nations can use these modern goods and thereby increase their standard of living. Obviously, in countries like India or in other developing nations or in underdeveloped nations, the people are now blessed to make use of the products with advanced technologies manufactured in other developed nations but made available in these developing and underdeveloped countries. So by buying and consuming such advanced products or innovative products, the standard of living of the people in developing countries and underdeveloped countries is well enhanced. And that is what the way by which they find increase in their standard of living. The next one is about rapid economic growth. International marketing promotes economic activities in the economy of parent nation, that means home country. It results in increase in national income and thereby promotes economic growth in the economy. I can say, if an Indian company gets into international marketing, whatever the revenue generates in the host country market is brought down by the Indian company to the home country, which is India. By virtue of that, the economic growth of India is increasing. And the sixth point of benefit is optimum utilization of global natural resources. Yes, in the past, companies restricted themselves to make use of the resources available only in their home country market. Might be to manufacture the products, or might be for distributing the products, or might be for promoting the product. Whatever the resources available in the home country market were alone utilized by companies. But now, due to globalization, the companies are enabled to make use of the resources available in the entire global village. There is no restriction at all. So due to international marketing, one nation can use the national resources available in other nations. A good example, Arabian nations are blessed to have the natural resources of oil. They have the resources which is more than their requirement. By now distributing or selling such natural resources to other countries, their economy is improved and they are able to generate a lot of revenue. And this is the idea stated here. And the next one is about strengthens international ties. International marketing brings participating nations closer to each other. It results in increased interaction among people of different nations. It promotes international cooperation and helps to strengthen international ties. It in turn improves international relations. Around the globe, many countries are involved with certain trade agreements. A good example that comes to my mind is NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement. This NAFTA facilitates free trade among the three membering countries. And similarly, you find there is a trade agreement among the six tigers of the world. And likewise, quite a lot of trade agreements that have been taken place between the countries which have different forums altogether. So that really strengthens the international relations between the countries. And the next one is about benefits to consumers. The first benefit, wider choice. Consumers are blessed to have wider choice of the products and services what they want to consume. In the past, the consumers were able to buy and consume the market offerings of only companies of the home country. But now we find in the home country market, products of many international companies or global companies are made available. So sitting in our own place, we are able to buy the products manufactured by companies from nook and corner of the world. So it facilitates wider choice of the products and services we would like to look into and select the most appropriate and suitable alternate of the product or service for our personal consumption. And the next one is about better quality goods. Obviously, the competition which is ignited between the companies of the home country and the companies of the foreign countries, it contributes for manufacturing and marketing best quality goods. We find the quality of the products they offer is really, really improved. And finally, we as consumers get benefited upon it. And the third benefit to consumers is goods available at low price. Yes, when the market size is expanded for every company and when the competition is ignited between the companies, they definitely manufacture the products at lower cost and make the products available at a very, very competitive price in order to delight their target customers well ahead of their competitors. So finally, we as consumers get the benefit of buying our favorite brands at lower price. And that is what the idea behind the third point, which is the benefits to consumers. I hope I have done my lecture up to your level of satisfaction. I'll meet you in another video. Thanks for watching this video as well. Bye for now, everyone.